make all the demons quiet. Yeah, we were built to thrive, yeah. I think that we've all had enough. What keeps you up at night, yeah? Make all the demons quiet, yeah. We were built to thrive, yeah. Yeah, I think that we've all had enough. What keeps you up at night, yeah? Make all the demons quiet, yeah. We were built to thrive, yeah.
We'll be right back. Hello and welcome. I am Joseph DeVoice, and we are here at Carthage Firebirds Esports Arena, and I am hanging out with none other than Blaze. How are you doing today, Blaze?
Yeah, I'm doing well. Getting ready to watch some more Rocket League.
And this is going to be quite the action today. There's 3 days coming up of competition that is going to be taking place Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and anything can happen here. We have three Firebirds teams that are going to be taking it on, and like I said, we were talking just before this, and at any given point, it could be Carthage against Carthage potentially in the finals. And crazy.
It'd be insane just that three chances for teams to just come together to play, you know, right next to each other.
And not only just that, but undefeated team throughout the NECC playoff champs. You know, these guys really showed out, and I'm just excited to see what's going to play out going forth. So as we get ready here, everybody just hang tight, and we will be getting started just shortly.
See your future on the horizon? So do we.
It's really just the greatest college experience I could have asked for.
What really drew me in was having an adventure.
I think something really unique about Carthage is that it constantly pushes you outside of your comfort zone.
At Carthage College, we will push you to dive deep, to channel your curiosity, and excel in your chosen field.
Been like an individual journey through collaborative effort, and so overall this has been my college experience, but so many people that I've met have been supportive along the way, and they're all looking out for you, so that's really why it feels like a family.
As you ignite your true potential and start asking the hard questions, you'll find the answers are just the beginning. That's the moment your purpose comes into view.
We are really able to get great one-on-one action with our professors. So you can't hide in your classroom. You're always actively participating.
You'll get recommended for things that you might not have ever been interested in before, and you end up realizing that that might be your passion.
Everyone here is just so nice, so welcoming. It's really easy to make friends here at Carthage. The biggest change was going from student to young business professional.
I love Carthage.
It's definitely the people.
Living on the lake is amazing.
I feel very prepared for my future.
Ended up surpassing my expectations.
Some things you just need to see for yourself. Come take a closer look at Carthage College.
All right, in our first matchup of the day, we have Carthage Firebirds A team, PD Nyrome and I Am Westoff, going up against University of British Columbia, Rome Destroyer, Kaziki, and Hystrix. If I'm saying them wrong, I'm saying them wrong, but I'm definitely going to do my best to do what I can while we're here, but it is going to be quite the matchup. Are you expecting anything in particular, Blaze, going into this one?
Definitely a strong start from Carthage. You know, we see through that they went undefeated. Definitely going to start out well for them. Maybe we'd see a little upset, but overall, great start for them is what I'm expecting here.
Definitely. I'm looking forward to kind of seeing what Nyrome does. The freshman's been really just showing up and showing out all year and really just looking to see what happens here. All right, and it's PD gets on up there, knocks it into the corner. Rome Destroyer right there to kick it right on back defense. It's PD going to knock it right back up. His teammate not there to clear it. Kaziki gonna drop it on down, almost getting into the goal, and right there, Rome Destroyer gets it in for the first goal of the game with 4:44 still left on the clock.
And I mean, I was wrong. Look at that. Just a fast start from Rome. Carthage defense, little scattered. They were able to capitalize on it. Put it right in between everybody was. Where?
All right, let's see if Carthage can come back quick right here. I'm Wes. I'm going to grab it and push it in the corner. Hystrix right there to grab it. It's Petey going to kick it on downfield. Rome Destroyer right back. Petey on top of it. Hystrix going to kick it into the corner. Rome Destroyer trying to make a play to kick it downfield. Nyrum going to grab hold of it. Good 50 there to slow him down. Hystrix put it out in front of the goal. Rome Destroyer right there, but just wide of the goal. I'm Wes. I'm going to grab it. Looking to try to make a pass over to It's Petey. It's Petey with a shot just high of the goal. Nyrum going to push it high. Kaziki pushes into the corner. Going to drive it on off. Pass it over to Rome Destroyer, just barely missing it. Nyrum gonna jump on top of it, try to kick it out towards the goal. I'm West off right there, but Hystrix kicks it away for a good save.
Carthage finally getting the pressure they need. PD had a nice center there, but no one there to capitalize on it. And they're just getting this pressure as soon as British Columbia is able to put one on. They're just immediately back there, as we see with a nice shot from Nyrum.
Let's see if Carthage can make a point here, bring it back to a 1-1. The pressure is on him right now. Kaziki gonna grab hold, kick it right back. Petey gonna knock it into the corner. Hystrix gonna try to put a little pressure.
Oh.
And it's Petey with the goal from the corner. Great angle. And just like that, with 3:26 left on the clock, it is 1-1. Carthage bringing it right back.
UBC definitely not thinking that was going in, but it was just such a wonderful angle for Petey to tie this one up.
Definitely. Let's see what continues to happen going forward. Now I'm trying to push on in front, trying to get fancy with it, but drops it. Kaziki gets on top of it. Oh, nice little shot just wide of the goal. Carthage starting to find a little bit more pressure, starting to add a little bit more in the mix right now. As long as they can keep on pressuring British Columbia, they look like they should be able to get another point on the board before British Columbia is able to do so.
Yeah, the one goal that was scored was just they were all over the place on defense, got a little scattered, and now that they've finally come together, they're just keep pressuring University of British Columbia. Yeah.
It's Petey gonna kick it off to the side. Rome Destroyer missing it. Petey still on top. Kaziki gets hold and throws it across the field for a good clear to Hystrix. Such an interesting name. Kaziki gonna kick it into the corner. It's Petey just keeping the pressure on him the best that he can, almost with a high shot by Rome Destroyer. Once again, Hystrix off the crossbar. Kaziki, once again, they are putting the pressure on him, and Rome Destroyer gets the goal. That is his second goal on three shots. They're going to have to find a way to slow him down going forward.
What a touch by Kaziki. Just able to put it completely awkward for the Carthage defense, and Rome just able to go put it in once again.
It is looking quite good for the British Columbia team right now, but I think Firebird A team still has a lot left in their tank. It's P going to kick it out in front. Haven't heard too much from Nyrum quite yet today, but let's see if we can get him started and get him going. I'm Wes. I'm going to try to get in front. Rome Destroyer right there, all over the field right now. Nyrum slowing him down. I think he might have found the secret weapon right there. You got to slow down Rome Destroyer if you want to get ahead in this one. I'm Wes, I'm dropping it downfield. But his team unable to capitalize there. Nyrum trying to push it on front for I'm Wes off. Rome Destroyer knocking it away again. That's a name we have been saying all day so far. Rome Destroyer's on it. And let's see if they can find a way to continue to slow down British Columbia. There it is. I am Wes off with the goal.
Nice play by PD. Sorry because he didn't have the greatest touch. It would just put it right by the two of them. Then straight out to Westhoff, who had an amazing shot on net.
Good passes back and forth by Team Firebirds A. It is 2-2 with 1:38 left on the clock. Can Carthage keep the pressure on and potentially bring it home for this victory in game one? I'm Westhoff just barely missing it. It's Petey trying to race on over, but Hystrix drops it into the corner. Nyrum pushes it downfield. Getting a fairly good bounce here. Petey finds his angle and knocks it on in. It's Petey putting his team up. 3-2 with 1:17 left on the clock.
It was an amazing shot from Petey. West was there. There was the fake. He got it right in between the two of them.
Quite the plays there by Team Firebirds A. Finding a way to mix it up. and getting it in. Nyrome grabbing into the corner, pushes it in front. Petey right there once again. Petey, take off your hands, people. He's done it. That is a hat trick.
Look at that. What a great pass. Kaziki's super awkward on defense. Petey's just able to squeak it in under the top bar.
The way that Carthage is moving around the field right now, they are making plays happen, and it is exciting to watch. If Team B and Team C can showcase the same type of plays that Team A is showing right now, we're going to have quite a few days of Rocket League to watch.
Yeah, Carthage definitely starting to feel it, too. We've seen it was a slower start, not what I was expecting, but they've just been able to put it together. These passes have been insane to each other. Just no matter what they do, it's been able to just put themselves in a great position to take a shot on net.
Hystrix staying on top of it, putting some pressure, trying to get it past the defender, faking out Petey a little there. But Nyrome gets on top of it, still in the corner. I am Westoff with the clear. Nyrome pushing it across. Rome Destroyer going to try to jump on top of it to push it across the field. Good positioning for Hystrix, but I am Westoff gets right on top of it and knocks it away. Carthage is in favorable positioning right now. Can Nyrome get the shot? It is slowed down by Rome Destroyer. Not surprised by that one. Rome Destroyer has been playing quite great for University of British Columbia, but it has not been enough for Team Firebird A. They are on fire right now.
It definitely have been. They finally, the ball, whenever is on their side, is there for like maybe 10 seconds. And then they've just been able to just capitalize and put it back on the other side. And it's definitely helped them secure this first game.
And just like that, the Firebirds take game one from the University of British Columbia. Petey, man, I tell you, he is definitely the leader for a reason. He shows up and he shows out when you need him to, and he leaves it all on the field. And the way that they're moving the ball around, the great passes that they're having, everything they're doing is definitely playing out the way you want to see it played out for, you know, Firebirds A team. And like I said, if they can find a way to continue to slow down Rome Destroyer, they're going to be in a much better position. Because as you can see, Rome Destroyer was everywhere on the field to start the game. That first half of the game, it was pretty much Rome Destroyer's game. But then Carthage found a way to make mid-game adjustments, and then towards the end of the game was able to capitalize and take home the victory. So,
yeah, Rome just being the main source of offense on the British Columbia team is the reason they were still in that game. The other two were there when they needed to be, but Rome Destroyer was able to put them in, was able to put them in the positions, and that's where they started falling apart on defense, because when he wasn't there, Carthage was able to set up a nice pass and put a goal in.
Definitely, and if Kaziki and Hystrix can put on any more pressure, we're going to have a little bit more of a match to watch. We're going to be seeing some overtime matchups going forward. But we are getting ready for game two. Can Carthage continue to just drive it home? Or will the University of British Columbia show them a little bit of fight? Let's see what happens here. It's Petey trying to get an early one on the double tap and just wide of the goal. Rome Destroyer right there.
Would have been an amazing start. Definitely set a momentum setter if you're scoring a double tap right off the kickoff.
Definitely. Just want to try to set the tone and get that mentality running early that you guys are there to show up and show out, and you guys are there to win most of all. Hystrix going to try to drop it in the corner, but Petey right there to kick it away. Petey with a good drop downfield. It looks free, and it is indeed. Petey puts it in for the goal.
There's so much commotion on that net. Rome couldn't get up to that ball, but then Hystrix and Kaziki was trying to get to that ball, and they could, neither of them could, so Petey was just able to put it right past him.
A little bit of an overcommit there by the University of British Columbia, indeed, and Petey capitalizing on it, noticing the gap downfield, getting it over to the defenders and knocking it in for the goal. Petey once again driving it to the corner, staying on top of the pressure by Petey right now is tremendous. He wants his NECC title, and you can see it. He is hungry.
As he puts a nice one on the backboard, Petey's just out for those balls and is able to put pressure on the net whenever he needs to, as Westoff puts in a nice goal.
And I am Westoff indeed. These guys are finding these nice little subtle hits. As you can see, it's not much, but it's enough to get it just past the defender and drives it on home for that goal right there, putting up Carthage Firebirds A 2-0 with only still 4 minutes on the clock.
This is definitely what I expected in game number one, but now they're finally comfortable. They're getting into their play style. They're not letting British Columbia do anything that they want, and they're just taking control of this game.
See, I'm getting confused. Are they the Firebirds or the Rising Phoenix? Because they're on fire and they're rising from the supposed ashes of undefeatedness to just keep on driving it home. This is awesome to see. Rome Destroyer kicks it in the corner. Petey gonna jump on top of it, drives it downfield. Kaziki just tries to hit it away, but Petey once again right there to keep the pressure on them. I don't know if University of British Columbia has what it takes to slow down Petey right now. Last game was Rome Destroyer, this game it's Petey, and he has not slowed down since last game, getting those three goals, and he just keeps on pushing it home. Hishrick's gonna try to get it here and just gets it past the defender and brings it right back to a 2-1. University of British Columbia finding a hole and sneaking it in for that goal.
It's very awkward for Carthage to do anything in that position. One was a little high on the wall. They were all trying to rotate back, and they just found the hole for it and were able to start bringing it back in.
Nyron with a good kickoff there. Very favorable, but just barely missing it there. But Petey once again to get the pressure. He saw the miss, and he got there, and he helped out his teammate. That's what you want to see on the field. Accidents happen on the field, but it's making sure you can capitalize and come back from those mistakes and make sure your team knows that you are there to help them out.
He's been able to do that all series. Mainly been helping out his team. We saw with him many passes and even just being in position like that, right underneath the ball and able to put it in.
It's a party over on the University of British Columbia side. All three of the Firebirds players were right there in front of goal. They could have danced for a minute and they still would have scored that goal. It was free as ever. If they can continue playing like this, keeping the pressure and just driving it home, I don't know what team is going to be able to slow them down right now. The University of British Columbia needs to find something to mix it up to slow down this Firebirds A team, but I don't think it's going to happen. Petey with a nice shot downfield. Kaziki right there to grab it out of the air, and Kaziki staying on top of it. Rome Destroyer looking to try to make a play, but Petey once again with the defend. Hendricks drives it across. Petey kicks it away. This man, I swear, there's two or three of him on the field right now. He's everywhere. If Petey continues to play at this level of play, I am telling you, no one can stop him. We have another hat trick. I don't even think I should have my hat on anymore. I'm just gonna have to not wear it the rest of this game because, every game, it's a hat trick with this guy. What is going on? Petey is on fire.
He's just able to solo the team there. Drove it around the corner. No one was there to stop him. He just put it in.
This is a crazy, crazy performance by the Firebirds, but it is to be expected. They are the undefeated squad, and they are not going to go down without a fight. Nyrom getting on over there. Just hold the pressure to give his team a moment to get back. It's Petey getting into position. Nyrom staying on top. Petey kicks it away. Good pass there. Once again, Petey going to kick it out. And his team just pressuring a little too far forward. I'm Westhoff right there to try to get some pressure, and Rome Destroyer sneaks in that goal there and brings it to a 4-2 with 1:36 left on the clock. Are they reading the same book at this point, or does Firebird still have their own playbook in their hands? We got to see what's happening here. They're starting to figure it out a little bit with 1:36 on the clock. What will the University of British Columbia do to try to come back here? Nyrom trying to dance around. Rome Destroyer staying on top of it. Nyrom doesn't have enough boost to make a play. They're going to rotate back. Smart play there. Kaziki trying to do something fancy, but the ball just kind of lofting on down there. University of British Columbia trying to get it away, but it's Petey finding the capitalization and once again driving it home. Man, this team is indeed the Firebirds. They are literally torching their opponents right now on the field. Primarily, Petey is just doing everything he can defensively, offensively. He is everywhere and anywhere that he can be right now.
Petey, had 800 points already. We still have a minute left of this game. They're just on fire, doing whatever they want. They got that insurance goal, so they got three to work with, and that's especially what you want with 3 minutes left as Rome snuck one in the top right corner.
Rome is a sneaky little bugger, I tell you. He keeps on sitting in front of goal and picking every shot he can when he finds them, and sometimes that's what needs to happen. They're starting to find it together a little bit on University of British Columbia, but like you said, that insurance goal might have been the deal sealer here. We have 57 seconds left on the clock. Let's see what happens. Nyrom gonna try to kick it into the corner. It's Petey right there to drop it on down just high. Rome Destroyer shooting it downfield, trying to get the gold. I am Westhoff playing it safe, playing it patient, and driving it away. It's Petey with a good clear here. I am Westhoff trying to get over, but does not get the hit. Hystrix kicks it across. I am Westhoff with the goal. Man, this whole Firebirds team is starting to figure it out. University of British Columbia starting to get a little bit of rhythm, but Firebirds is, they're shutting it down. They are not allowing it to happen. 6-3, 36 seconds left on the clock. Blaze, what do you think is going to happen here in the rest of this game?
I think we're going to see a start to slow down. Maybe British Columbia needs to score just a goal to give themselves a little momentum going into game number three. But with Nyrome hitting a shot like that,
I don't know what to do with my hands right now. Do I put him here? All I know is, this is crazy, people. Nyrome with another goal. 7-3 with 30 seconds left on the clock. I don't think University of British Columbia would have expected such a dominant force from the Firebirds A team. But like I'm saying, they're undefeated for a reason. They are here to show why they're here. Oh my goodness, Petey. Man, I need to go get his autograph after this game, I'm telling you. We need all the children in chat. If you want his autograph, tell us now. We'll get it to you. Because this man's going to go pro at some point. If he keeps at this level of play, it's ridiculous. I got goosebumps.
What a play by Petey. You know, British Columbia are kind of just falling apart now. They're doing whatever they want. They have full control of the backboard, the corners, the entire side, the entire field.
This is absolutely crazy. University of British Columbia does not have an answer. It's Petey still keeping the pressure on, trying to drop it down in front of goal. But his team decided to be nice there. They said, we're going to stay back. We're just going to let the time kill, Petey. We know you want these goals, but we also want this game to end. There's, like, no time left on the clock. Let's just run it out. And just like that, they're still playing with them. They're still toying with them with 0 seconds on the clock. Petey's trying to end the game, and there we go. Firebirds once again coming home victorious. Quite the matchup.
Just to show Petey's brilliance in that game, 1,000 points. Over 1,000 with 5 goals and 9 shots, just completely doing whatever he wanted in this game too.
I'm not wearing the hat for a reason, people. That man, he almost had 2 hat tricks. I don't have that many hats, Petey. I don't have that many hats, but if you're gonna keep on playing like this, I'm just not gonna wear it. How about that? We're getting ready for game three. Let's see what happens here. All right, Firebirds A team. Will they keep this same momentum and drive it home and take the victory here in this matchup? I'm Wes. I'm just going to drop it down, trying to get a second tap there, but doesn't play out. Hystrix with the demo. It's Petey staying patient there, grabbing hold of it, kicking it away once again. Rome Destroyer trying to put it in front of goal. Oh, a correction. Rome Destroyer trying to get the pass. It's Petey kicking it across to the corner. And right there's I am Westhoff. Nope, that was Nyrome. Sorry about that. They're moving so quick right now, it's hard to even see the names. I'm Westhoff gonna kick it away. And we have a player that dropped out of the game. Stand play, people. All right, as we walk through this technical difficulty, just give it a moment and we'll be back to the gameplay just here shortly. We had a connection issue. Somebody timed out. We are working on resetting the lobby. I wonder if... All right, we have the lobby set back up. We're just going to make sure everything is good to go here, and we are going to start this matchup right back up. Just got to make sure our lobby is good to go.
Now we're seeing definitely a different start than we did in the last game. The initial game three started off so weird. Both teams were kind of just giving the ball to each other and letting them do whatever. Now we're starting to see it was like the end of game two now, where they're applying pressure, taking control of the ball, and playing together Rocket League.
I thought that they just cloned Petey and they had two of them on the field. To be honest with you, the way that he's playing is absolutely phenomenal right now, and I don't know if University of British Columbia nor any other team in this conference right now can find a way to slow him down. So if he continues to play at that level of play, 1,000 points a game, nobody can stop that. That's absolutely ridiculous. And not to mention, I'm Westoff and Nyrom are also making plays at the same time, pushing the ball around the field and just making it happen, setting up Petey. But Petey has just been everywhere that he can be. Kazeki gonna kick it downfield into the corner. Nyrom gonna try to grab hold, but Kazeki staying on top of it. I'm Westoff pushing it across. Petey giving a good set to his teammate. I'm Westoff, not the most favorable pass across field. It's Petey, I don't think meant to do that backflip there. But it's Petey trying to come right back and gets the tap in from Rome Destroyer. I won't call it luck because he's been doing it all day.
Good shot too, got it over the two right in front of him. Had to get it in a super awkward position for Rome. And it was awkward, and that's why it was bounced the way it did, right back into their net.
With 3 minutes and 44 seconds left on the clock, Petey once again doing everything he can to drive home this victory. And right there, I am Westoff in front, barely missing the mark. Petey gonna kick it in front, and Petey once again. This is why I told you people, I'm not wearing a hat anymore for this matchup, because he's gonna do it again. It's gonna be another hat trick, I'm telling you right now. 3:33 on the clock only means that there's going to be a third goal from Petey, I'm telling you. I don't believe in coincidences.
Petey's just taking control of this game. There's nothing British Columbia can do. Just no matter what, he is there and he's putting in a shot.
I am Westoff trying to kick it in front of goal. Hystrix kicks it away. Nyrom grabbing hold of it. Hystrix once again doing everything he can for his team to just try to apply the pressure to this Firebirds A team. Rome Destroyer getting it out in front. Kazeki right there hits it just wide of the goal. Nyrom doing a good job at keeping it moving downfield. It's Petey trying to add a little pressure in goal to Rome Destroyer. I'm Westoff trying to get on over. Rome Destroyer getting a good hit on it, but it's Petey puts it out in front, and I called it, people! It's Petey with another hat trick. 2:50 on the clock. It's Petey on fire.
Is that a hat trick of hat tricks?
That's a hat. I think, is that like a hard hat of tricks? Did you get like a golden hat of tricks? How does this work? Somebody tell me how this works. Because it's Petey, they can't slow him down. Now I'm going to drive it over from the corner. He does not. He just makes a play in front of goal to kick it away. Good play there by Nyrom. Nyrom once again grabbing hold of it, but Hystrix puts a little bit of pressure on him, and Kazeki just drives it away. University of British Columbia has barely even been able to get it in front of that Firebirds goal, and just like that, Kazeki puts it on in. It's like I was feeling something there. You gotta have a little bit of competition in these matchups. There's just a roll-off effect, and Kazeki gets it on in, bringing them back 1-3 with 2:22 left on the clock. Do they have an answer? Can University of British Columbia take home a win in this matchup? I just don't know if I see it.
Wait, just the way Carthage is playing, they've had all the pressure, they have all the shots, as that ball would have gone in if somebody was there. There's nothing British Columbia has been able to do to stop them so far, and I can't see that stopping in the next 2 minutes.
I mean, at this point, I think they just need all three defenders to be in goal at all times to slow down Petey, because he's finding holes even when they are in front of goal, so. And if his team continues to set him up the way that they are and continue to play that they are, nobody's gonna be able to slow them down. Just like that, I am Westoff trying to set up Nyrom and barely misses the mark. Like I said, these team plays from the Firebirds are on point right now. Nyrum gets a good kick upfield, trying to get fancy with it, but gets met at the mark. I'm Wesso trying to kick it back, but Hystrix gets a good hold of it, and Hystrix just barely misses. Double crossbar! Come on, University of British Columbia, get it together! Kazeki right there with the goal. It is 3-2, and Kazeki is the only one that has an answer right now for this Firebirds team.
Wow, just that was crazy to watch. They had two open nets there. Just sidebar. Gave them a little bit of frustration, but they were able to put it back in and give themselves a little more hope in this last game.
Will we see an overtime here with 1:10 left on the clock, or will the Firebirds just be able to shut them down and shut them out? Nyrone keeping the pressure on. It's Petey kicking it across for I Am Westhoff, but Hystrix right there to grab it. I Am Westhoff not allowing them to drive it downfield. It's Petey with a decent clear, but Kazeki gets a touch on it. University of British Columbia is finding ways to add that additional pressure right now, but is it enough? With 38 seconds left on the clock, will we see an overtime? I am leaning towards the edge of my seat right now because anything can happen. Kazeki just gonna drop it on down, and I Am Westhoff almost there to get the shot on goal. Looks like at this point, Firebirds are just trying to waste time. They're keeping the pressure on, but they're not adamantly just aiming at goal. They're trying to run on the sidewalls. They're trying to kill that time. They want it to stay zero, and they want to take home this win. Kazeki with their shot down goal, and Kazeki gets the hat trick to bring it back. Just like that, people, I told you, anything can happen. And Kazeki gets the shot downfield, brings it to overtime. Holy cow!
Just what a shot from Kazeki. Just across the field, only shot they had left, and it goes in. Carthage really has to just shut the door here now. Can't let any momentum start for British Columbia.
Did somebody hand Aaron Rodgers a controller? Because that was like a Hail Mary you see when you're at Lambeau Field, and it worked. Rome Destroyer gonna try to stay on top and try to find a play up top and barely misses the mark. British Columbia looking like they might have found something here. Keeping the pressure on the Firebirds. They don't want to go home just yet. They are fighting with all the will in their heart. Rome Destroyer gets it knocked away by It's Petey. What is going to happen here? Do they have the answer? Kazeki has been the only one to be able to see through the holes of the Firebirds defense. I'm Westhoff getting out in front, but not able to drive it home. They're good defense by Hystrix. Rome Destroyer putting it out in front. Nyrone kicks it away. But Kazeki there again, trying for the double tap, and Kazeki does not get the goal. Oh my goodness, people.
Nyrone just barely able to save that. It was pixels away from going in. And is that gonna give Carthage enough momentum to score here? They got the pressure now.
That thing looked closer than the shaves that I do. And it didn't go in. I am just completely flabbergasted by that one. But Firebirds still got enough in the tank. They wanna seal the deal.
What a pass.
And just wide of the goal, Nyrum trying to get it in, gets demoed by, Rome is just demoing everybody he can. He wants nobody else on the field but his team.
He's so close to getting that third two, and it's given them so much pressure now. Carthage is on their corner with no boost. They're all trying to get back to the ball, but no one on British Columbia went to go pressure that.
It's Petey gonna try to drive it out for I'm Westhoff. Rome Destroyer gets a good defender. Hystrix trying to find the angle, but Nyrum says no. Nyrum in a great position, barely misses the mark. Who will come home victorious? Are we gonna have a 13-minute overtime like we saw yesterday in the pros? It is crazy out here in Rocket League, people.
The back and forth we're seeing right now between these two teams, no one's letting up. No matter what one does, the other does the same thing back. It's been pretty much stalled out. so far this overtime.
It looks like each team kind of has an answer for almost everything the other opponent is throwing at them. But there's gotta be an opening. There's gotta be someone who just misses the mark just enough for it to break through for either the Firebirds or the University of British Columbia. When is it gonna happen? We are already 3 minutes into overtime and they are fighting. They are clawing and nailing their way. Both teams just trying to find a way to bring home this win in game three. Rome Destroyer tries to get the defend. Nyrom trying to push it out in front for his teammates. They fall back a little bit just to make sure that there wasn't a good clear there.
Carthage has ultimately had the pressure the last like half minute here, as we see Westhoff with almost an open shot, but Kaziki really trying his best here to keep his team in this.
Kaziki is that golden ticket to keep University of British Columbia alive, indeed. He has been clawing and fighting with every ounce of his will. It's Petey putting it out in front and not able to get it in. I am Westhoff with a good attempt. It's Petey is trying to narrow down the field and find an opening. Hystrix almost able to capitalize there, just high of the goal. Hystrix once again just keeping the pressure on. And it's Petey with a good clear downfield. I am Westhoff trying to set something up here, and Kaziki right there with the good defend. We have almost completed an entirety of a second Rocket League match at this point. This is exciting.
Oh, what a pass by Westhoff.
And Nyrom knocks it in. Let's go. 4:49 in overtime. And Nyrom gets the win.
What a pass by Westhoff. Got a great recovery on the wall. Saw his teammate waiting there and put it straight to him and gave him a wonderful shot on net.
The patience from this Carthage team. The rigorous attack of Petey throughout the matchup. This is why the Firebirds A team is undefeated. And as I told you guys, I'm still not wearing my hat. I'm still not wearing it. There's no point to put it on if the Firebirds continue to play at this level.
It's just a lot for this team to do right now. We saw just an immaculate game two, then a little bit of a quick game three, long game three that just went straight all the way.
Yeah, I mean, at the end, you saw there that they weren't willing to just fall down lightly. Between Rome Destroyer, Kaziki, Hystrix, they were trying to find a rhythm. Kaziki giving everything he has to try to push it into overtime. Not enough to meet the mark, though. But I'm telling you, this Firebirds A team, you guys are going to keep on watching as they continue to play out. Firebirds BC matches. Thanks for watching. We'll be back on later tonight. Low cut.